All right, guys. Go ahead and fire away.
Patrick, you played against Josh Uche last year with the Patriots. Mm-hmm. What do you remember about him? What's your sort of game plan for him?
Yeah, I mean, I think obviously, I mean, a great pass rusher, someone that can really get to the QB, especially in those pass rush situations. I think he does a great job of playing hard the entire time too, which is sometimes you get guys that kind of take their chances in their spots and stuff like that, but he's a guy that gets after it every single snap he gets. And so I think it's a great addition to an already great defense. I think his specialty will be able to really be emphasized in this defense.
As you're able to integrate DeAndre more and more, what do you think that might do for the downfield passing as you go?
Yeah, I think whenever you're able to put him in there, obviously we're going to be able to hit some throws down the field, but I think hitting him kind of over that medium to long range is going to open up other guys down the field and take pressure off other guys as far as eyes and coverage. And so whenever you got, I mean, really two guys, when you talk about DeAndre and Trav, that are all kind of working in that medium-type range in the football field, it opens up the deeper throws because teams have to account for that.
What's the challenge been like for you with the injuries and just different people in the room when you guys are trying to work yourself through making all that stuff happen?
Yeah, I think the challenge comes more throughout the week just because you're putting new guys in different positions and ask them to go out there and execute. But once you get the work in throughout the week, I think we've done a great job of executing on game day and hitting some of those throws. I mean, obviously, it's forced guys to have bigger roles than we expected early in the season. But at the same time, I feel like guys have kind of accepted the challenge, and that's why we've been able to win the games that we've been able to win.
Talk about a lot of plays where it seemed like you sort of planted and grew and made up your mind pretty quickly yesterday. Is that a result of something you were working on?
Yeah, for sure. And I think it's just having a good game plan. We had a good feel for what they were going to do, and guys were getting open. And so I give guys chances to make some plays. And when you play a defense like that with the type of pass rush that they have, you have to get the ball out on time. And so we did that this last week, and now let's build upon it. Let's obviously continue to do that, but let's get back to throwing some of the deep passes and then running the ball as well.
A lot of teams playing these shell coverages that a couple years ago you might have had to sort of read and react to it, but you're seeing it quicker. How much is that helping you? And I just wonder if you agree with that assessment.
Yeah, for sure. I think when I was younger, I wanted to throw it deep every time. There's good and bad to that. And so I think more than anything, it's just finding that right balance of still pushing it down the field, but at the same time taking what's there and moving the chains. And I think we've done a great job of that, and I think as we've started to execute better in the red zone, we've been able to score more and more points. And so we're going to continue to just work to get better, and we want to be playing our best football by the end of the year.
With the knowledge that your defense is such a strength, it's been that way for the past 2 years, has it changed a little bit of your offensive mentality even still, just maybe in slightly more conservative in a sense?
I think I don't want to say more conservative, but definitely once you get a lead, you know that defense is going to get stopped. So We want to go in and score as many points as possible. I'm not going to act like we don't want to score. But in certain situations where we might have pressed the issue and try to force something to make something happen, knowing that our defense can get stops and that we can punt and we can get the ball back in a better type of position on the field, it speaks to the entire team. And I think that's something that I've kind of evolved throughout my career.
Patrick, the WNBA is looking to expand as a quarterback.
Yeah, I mean, obviously, we want to get basketball to Kansas City in general, and then WNBA and the success that they've had this last season and these last few seasons, it's kind of a no-brainer. I mean, to try to get a WNBA team in Kansas City to this fan base. I mean, you see it if you talk about Kansas, University of Kansas basketball, the Chiefs, or whatever it is, the city of Kansas City is going to come out and they're going to fill the stadium. And so it was cool that we were able to get this soccer team, this women's soccer team here in the current, and they're going into the playoffs now, and you see the support that they have. And so let's try to get a WNBA team in here as well, and kind of that same type ownership group. And they've done the current the right way, and I want to continue to work with them to take that next step and get a WNBA team here.
The Rawls Business School and study marketing down at Tech. How important is that, or how beneficial was that when you were in the room talking?
Yeah, I think just seeing just how business works, it's helped me throughout my entire career. I mean, the preparation when I went to the Rawls Business School was that I was going to hopefully be a athlete, and I was going to be able to know more than just being an athlete and letting someone else handle all my other businesses outside of football. And it's prepared me to be in some of these meetings that I've been in, and I get to see it from both sides, as a player and as a owner, or whatever you want to call it, manager, whatever it is. And it helps me put my perspective and my input into these meetings that I meet with these other leagues, and I can kind of show how hopefully we can make it a great place for owners, but a great place for players as well.
Yeah,
Back to the WNBA for a second. Just can you remind us why it's been important for you to be involved in the Royals and sporting and everything you're involved with?
Yeah, I think, I mean, just because Kansas City is such a great place for me. It's a place that I call home. It's a place that I built a house at and that I'll be for a long, long time. And so I think being involved in the community as much as possible, and I love sports. I know how much the city loves sports. And so let's bring as many sports in here and showcase how great Kansas City is, not only as a city, but the people that are in the city as well.
That's enough. How realistic, I mean, is the timetable on the WNBA talks? I mean, they seem to want to go pretty
fast. Yeah, they want to expand. I mean, just like any other business, you have to kind of pick and choose how to expand. You want to expand as fast as you can, but you want to do it in a way that's profitable for them, but also good for the players and the quality of the sport. And so, obviously, you've seen this last few years. The WNBA has really grown. And so we feel like Kansas City is a great place to continue that growth. But we have to battle with other cities to prove why we can sustain and have a great franchise here.
You've established that this is important to you. How far do you foresee your ownership ventures or investment ventures going in sports? I mean, do you have any broader plan you know right now, or you just will keep moving it?
No, I wouldn't say a broader plan, not necessarily. I think more than anything, I just know how much sports has given to me. And so whenever I'm done playing football, whenever that is, and I have to venture off into life after football and chasing kids around and everything like that, I want to be able to still be a part of it. And so obviously it started early with the Royals, then sporting, then the current, and now hopefully we can get this WNBA team here. And it's for life after football, so I can still make an impact in all sports. And then at the same time showcase to my daughter that she can follow her dream and go out there and execute whatever that dream is.
Patrick, Jody Fortson shared that he tore his ACL on Sunday. You've known him for 5 years now, I guess. How tough is it to see, you know, a guy like that you've been around to go through yet another tough injury like that?
Yeah, it's extremely tough just because you know how hard he's worked to get back from the injuries that he's had in the past. And he's such a good dude. I mean, he'll do whatever to be on that football field. He's one of those guys you're like, go block the middle linebacker. He'll go block the middle linebacker. He'll do whatever it takes to help your team win. And so you feel terrible. I mean, in the locker room after kind of somewhat getting the news, and you don't know for sure, but you kind of know. And you know how much it means for him, and it means a lot for us for him to be out there. And so obviously it's terrible news, but at the same time I know the human, I know the person, I know he'll continue to fight back and give himself another opportunity to get back out on that football field.
Patrick, I know you're not entirely happy with some of the stats this year with the interceptions. The last few have been really kind of out of your control in a couple of ways. On your maturity level at this point, how much easier is it for you to deal with things like that than maybe it would have been 5 years ago when you
I think more than anything, when we win, it doesn't hurt as bad. I mean, obviously, I want to be perfect. I want to be great. I don't want to put our defense in bad positions like I did the other day. But at the end of the day, I want to win. And however we have to win the football game, I'm good with it. If that's scoring a lot of touchdowns, that's not scoring touchdowns. If that's running the football, whatever it is, it's playing defense to win football games. I just want to win at the end of the day, and I think we're doing a great job of that.
Emily, why are women's sports so important to you too?
I said it a little bit. I mean, I think first, I mean, it's just a showcase to my daughter, who I believe loves sports so far. I mean, it's everything we do. She wants to hit the baseball off the tee. She wants to play soccer. I want to show that she can follow her dreams and make an impact in this world, and whatever that dream is. And then as I've met players and women from other sports that I've kind of been around, including my wife, and show that they didn't get some of the same things that I got coming up as far as the resources and the facilities and stuff like that. So I want to give them those same resources, those same facilities, and you've seen it with the current. Whenever you give them the best of the best, they go out and perform at an even higher level. And so I'm excited for the playoff run we're about to have with the current, and I want to continue to work in women's sports as long as I can.
Okay, thanks, Patrick.